Welcome you viewers to this episode. Now we are continuing with the experiments to determine the amount of air in soil samples. Now we finished the amount of air in the sand soil and we got 15 cubic centimeters. Now we are going to loam soil. Now we are also going to put in water 50 cubic centimeters. As you are seeing, so this is 50 cubic centimeters of water we are going to put in the loam soil. So now we are going to stir. Now we are stirring. Now as I'm stirring, you are seeing bubbles are moving out. Bubbles are moving out from the soil, and that is the sign that air is escaping, or it is a sign that this soil is having air. The bubbles are escaping. After seeing that all the soil is wet, then you stop stirring. Now although the soil is getting wet, so after seeing that all the soil is wet, then you read. So now my reading here is 63. So my reading is 63. So the volume will be for stirring. The volume after stirring in loam is 63 cubic centimeters. So meaning that when we subtract to get the amount of air, we get the original volume of volume before stirring, which was 80 cubic centimeters. So minus 63 cubic centimeters, then the amount of air here is, so when you get 80 minus 63, we get 17. So 17 cubic centimeters of air in loam soil. So that loam soil had 15 cubic centimeters. Now we are going to clay soils. So we are also going to put in 50 cubic centimeters of water. So these are the 50 cubic centimeters of water we are putting in 30 cubic centimeters of clay soil. So now after pouring in water, then you stir so that this water can enter soil, and when water enters soil, the pores in this soil are going to be replaced by water. So when the pores are replaced by water, now the air escapes. So now you are seeing, as I'm stirring, the bubbles are moving out of soil, and that means that the air is escaping, or the soil had air which is escaping or being replaced by water. So after seeing that all of the soil is wet, you stop. So now all our soil is wet. All our soil is wet. So you have to stir very well. So now after stirring, the final volume is 60. Volume after stirring in clay is 60 cubic centimeters. So meaning that the amount of air in a kilo, so when you get the initial volume, which was 80 cubic centimeters, minus 60, the final volume, 60 cubic centimeters, then you get 20 cubic centimeters of air in kilo. So, meaning that of all of the three, we are seeing that kilo is having the highest amount of air. The one which had less amount of air, the least amount of air was in sand. So now we are going to put the amount of air in percentage. We're going to put the amount of air. A question can ask you, how can you put the amount of air in percentage? So percentages, now we are going to start with sand. So amount of air of sand, the formula for putting it in percentage is amount of air out of total soil used. Total soil used, or amount of soil used times 100. So our amount of air in sand was 15, out of soil we used 30 times 100. So our percentage will be 15. It will be 50. Our percentage will be 50%. So, meaning that third soil had air 50%. Then the percentage for loam soil we are also going to get the amount of air we got in the loam soil, which was 17 out of total amount of soil used, which was 30 times 100. So the percentage of air in the loam, we get 17 out of 30, we get 57%. So loam had air 57%. Now we are going to get the percentage of air in kilo. Kilo, we get the amount of air in kilo, which was 20 out of 30 total soil used times 100. So our kilo So meaning that this sap of soil of kilo had 67% air, and this one of loam had 57% air, then this one of sand had 50% of air. Now they can also ask a reason, why is sand having 50, and why is kile loam having 57, and why is kile having 67? This means this air in the sand being 50, or sand having the lowest amount of air, that means sandy. This is because sand has few pores. This sand has few pores compared to the rest. That's why it is having the lowest amount of air. Then low, high, moderate air or medium amount percentage of air or amount of air, because low has also medium pores. Then it has the highest amount of air because it has the highest a lot of pores. It is having a lot of pores which contain air. That's why it is having a lot of air, because the pores are very many which contain air. So that is the reason for these answers. Now they can ask you another question. Of what importance is this experiment to the farmer? So, the first reason, this experiment enables the farmer to know the best soil for crop growth. It enables the farmer to know the best soil for crop growth. It also enables the farmer to find out the best soil, the best crop. It also enables the farmer to find out the best crop suitable in a particular soil. So enable the farmer to know the best crop suitable in a particular soil. Then another importance of this experiment to the farmer, it enables the farmer on how to improve the soil which is not suitable. It enables the farmer to improve on the soil which is not, remember the farmer, how to improve the soil which is not suitable for crop growth. So now after seeing the three, the farmer will be able to tell, but this soil is not good, it's having less air, so let me improve it. So now we are going to see how the farmer can improve the soil which is not suitable. How can the farmer improve the soil which is not suitable? How can the farmer improve the soil which is not suitable? So the first one, the farmer can mix, in most cases sandy soil is the one which is not suitable for crop growth. So the farmer can mix sandy soil with clay. Mixing the sandy soils with clay soils. So this means now the farmer will have formed the loam soil, which is the best for crop growth. Because when you compare all these particles, when you combine all the particles, that means the properties are going to be medium or moderate. So also the farmer can mulch. So the farmer can put lime in. The farmer can put lime in the soil. And when lime is put in clay soil, that lime will separate the clay particles so that air can enter. When it is put in loam, particles will be closed, pores will be reduced, therefore It will have medium properties. So now with this experiment is almost done. Now we shall meet in the next episode.